Next episode, guys. It's been a couple of days since I finished this section here. I did kind of discover something bad. So if you remember, maybe you don't, then in the winter time I hauled in a bunch of lumber here. So I bought wet lumber, hoping that in half a year time that thing will just nicely dry up and I could use it then for the cabin, but apparently there was not enough airflow through this area and things kind of went sideways. Whole this pile is totally messed up. There is mold everywhere, so this plan kind of backfired on me. Luckily not all of them went bad. So a little bit over an half I did manage to store here. At least these are fine and I can use them. But yeah, these, pretty sure I can't use them inside ever again. I could probably use them outside, but they will never turn like white again. They will always stay greenish. Even if it dries out nicely, it will still have this green ugly color to it. So yeah, that's that. Anyway guys, this episode is completely about finishing off the porch area. Leaving it like this is a bit unsafe, so I should probably add some railings here as well. I was thinking maybe I should do a staircase down there. Not sure how useful that will be, but maybe it's okay. Need to figure out what to put here. This is kind of too steep even for me. What else? Oh yes, also these diagonal supports. I need to get rid of them. Obviously they're not here to stay. So let's start this episode off with the diagonal supports. I can remove these. These are completely useless and I don't need them right now. So guys, if this happens, the screw will not come out because it's too deep in there. Here's what you do. This one will keep the timber in place and then you can get the other one out. Another problem that might occur. The screw head is filled with crap and you just can't get a grip. Take another screw, try to drill out the head a bit. Should work. What? 25. Never mind that. Next time just use the right bit, I guess. Okay, like I said, I didn't need these diagonals anymore. That's because this wall is tied to that wall with these roof trusses. And the thing will not move that way or that way. Currently, if you apply enough force, the thing will move that way or that way. So before I remove all of them, I need to make sure that there are some permanent diagonal supports here. What style should I use? I want it to be like beefy. I think beefy is good. Some people would probably put the support here. That would work. Personally, I would put it down. Something like down here. I've been literally standing here for like 10 minutes now. This is ridiculous. Stopping. Okay. I got some more sketchy tire content for you guys. How is that thing even working? I do not get it. I think those tires need some air. Thank you. something's amiss. Cutting all dried out birch is no fun at all. This corner diagonal, excessively overpowered. By the way, when I was doing sawmilling, I was thinking, should I cut this up to firewood? It was only like 2 meters long and I didn't think I could get any use out of this thing. Now I'm really glad I did not do that. This fits here very nicely. Now I can safely remove all the other diagonals. Seems fine. You know, I can't feel any motion, so I'm pretty sure it's secure. So this thing is supposed to stabilize this whole area in those two directions. Anyway, let's add a couple of diagonals here as well. Birch, really tough stuff. I guess that's why they make plywood out of the stuff. This is gonna be a bit tricky to do. It would be right to do like a notch in here and then anchor it there. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna mess that up. I need more screws. Okay, the thing has more screws in it now than I can count. If you smell burning sound or think the thing is hot, just run it full throttle without any load. An electric motor running without any load is the fastest and most efficient way to cool it down. Okay, these two should do something useful here. Next up, the railings. This part can also be considered as a guide how to make barbecue charcoal. This is gonna take a while. Anyway, the bottom railings are finished. So yeah, came out pretty okay, I guess. Next up would be to do some kind of a top surface here. I still have some of these decking boards left. I was thinking, let's just turn this upside down and use this as top surface. The bottom side is pretty smooth and nice, so why not? I think the height is okay. This height can be used for two modes, either thinking about something or being proud about something. Or you can just chill like this. A week ago it was raining all day, every day, but now that I have a roof on top of me, there is no rain. I wonder why is that? That is unfair. Okay, well, this area is pretty much figured out and finished. This one here though, I think this is a bit low. I was thinking I'm gonna add that to this side. You know, cut a straight line here, just like I did on the other side. Then again, if I cut a straight line here as well, then that means theoretically only about 5 centimeters of this beam will remain intact. So I think that would compromise the strength of these beams or posts, so I don't really want to risk that. Instead, I'm gonna get some 2x4 here and make some joints into that instead. Having a really long level has been really useful. I would definitely recommend getting a 3 meter level. The most useful tool I have ever bought. Battery powered circular saw. If you're eyeballing for one, I definitely recommend it. Had 1 6-meter long decking board remaining, and now I need a 6-meter long decking board. Don't you just love when things just work out. So I wanted this railing to be a bit higher, so nobody would get the bright idea to jump on here to do stupid stuff like this. Anyway, bottom porch railings are finished now. What to do next? Perhaps the balcony railings next? Nah, I'm kinda sick of railings right now. Let's build a staircase down here.
Is this?
My idea. I have a couple of these really ugly 4x4s. I've had them for years now and really haven't had any use for these two, but I think I can nicely use them for this staircase. This is fun. Seems solid. I think this should be solid enough. So if you're wondering what the crap is this, then this is gonna be a small deck area where the staircase will connect to. I also have an alternative motive for this small extra deck, but that will be a secret for now. Probably will be a secret for a while, because pretty sure I'm not gonna reach that far this year. To make sure that I'm not gonna make the staircase too steep, I'm gonna try to use the whole 6 meters as a grade. I need to also support it from the center, not just from the top and bottom. You're probably thinking, why do I need a staircase here? Well, to get down this hill, I need to walk like 5 meters. That's way too much effort. Why walk 5 meters when you can walk 0 meters? You know, the guy who brought me these said that one day they turned like 100 of these into the ground. Man, I'm dying after the first one. How did they do 100? You know what? I think it's not strong enough. Maybe this thing will do something. Yeah. Let's carry on here. Thank you. That was boring. Ooh. The last step is a bit much. Solid black leather. I think it goes pretty well hand in hand with the cabin. Maybe it will even look better if I add some railings. I don't know. Let's add some more stuff to it. Maybe it will be better. Needs more stuff. Kind of a party going on there. Either that or somebody's dying. Let's go check it out. Looks like they're having some kind of relationship problems. Man, those are some huge ass horns. Apparently the black and white one are going at it. I would go closer, but they're kind of aggressive right now, so... Oh well, looks like the party is over. Back to work. Almost. I think one more, for safety reasons. I I really like this method of sanding. If you want to do some rough sanding, just to make sure there are no splinters, this is by far the fastest method to do this. It is said that the belt sander is the fastest way to remove material, but this method really beats the hell out of the belt sander. This thing literally eats wood for breakfast. Need to do some stuff here as well. Oh man. What? This looks kind of weird. Some unbalance going on. Okay, that's a bit better. Dominoes. All right, well, I think it's safe enough. Need to fix this now. Kind of a big step, the last one. So I'm looking at two possible solutions. Number one would be that I would go and get a couple of loads from the gravel pit there and dump them here to make the ground level a bit taller. The second option would be a couple of boulders. So I think I'm gonna go with the boulder option. Don't feel like driving the excavator into the forest just to get one load. Seems like a huge waste of time. Let's go get some rocks. Hey buddy, don't you know how gravity works? Freaking douchebag! Man, I will roll over with this thing. Oh yeah, now you understand how gravity works. Sure. That's not a rock, by the way. This is a completely cured cement bag from eons ago. Everything goes. I need some more rocks. You know, now that I'm thinking about it, should have probably put some plastic under here. That way it would have prevented some unnecessary grass growth. Oh well, now I just need some rain to kinda smooth this thing out a bit. Maybe it's good enough for now. We'll see in the future. If this does not hold up, I can do something else here. Seems like the staircase is working. Wait a minute. What? The thing is not even parallel with the house. I mean, the house is pointing that way. The staircase kinda that way. How did this happen? Whatever. No way I'm starting over. I'm thinking this video is kinda getting long now. Every episode I start off imagining that I will do this, that, and also that. It will not take me any time at all. By the time I'm finished with the first task that I've set for the video, then I already have like 200 gigabytes of content to go through. Obviously, I don't know what the hell I'm thinking about. Let's try to finish this off. The last job for this video would be to add some railings to that balcony area. Because from here, it's kinda sketchy. From this angle though, the staircase looks awesome. It's a bit high maybe, but to be honest, it's the only lumber length that I have right now. That remotely kinda fits here. Maybe it being high is actually a good thing. So nobody would get the bright idea to climb over this thing. This design will also help to support the last roof beams. Some bottom railings now would be helpful. Thank you. boy. One more element, then I'm done. Kinda finished. I had a completely different thing in mind, but somehow I ended up with this pile of crap here. But I guess this will have to do for now. Anyway, I'm gonna start wrapping this video up. It's been a while and I'm kinda sick of this episode. I wanna move on. Gonna clean up today and then wrap this video up tomorrow. I really have to do clean up after each episode. Tons of cleanup. I always make a mess of things. Oh yeah, this is a lot better now. I'm getting so much barbecue material with this project. I'm literally making barbecue every other day. And this thing just keeps piling up. Got a bunch of rain during the night time. The rain nicely smooths out the sand, cleans the rocks. And hopefully these rocks will nicely stay where they are. Oh man, it looks like a prison up there. Maybe it's too high. Let me know in the comments what you think, guys. From this perspective, it looks quite okay. I mean, it's a bit high, but at least nobody can fall over it. Because the drop is quite severe. But from down here, thing literally looks like a prison. Oh well, at least it's a good prison. So guys, I'm gonna share a little clip with you here now. The clip was made last year, sometime during the spring. The video is about clearing this whole area. Removed a bunch of trees and stumps. There was a pond on this spot. I completely backfilled that and it's now mowable nice grass. So if you want, you can check that video out, but I'm gonna highlight only one scene of that video. So let's roll that clip now. I'm planning to rebuild this house this year, at least part of it. I want to make a porch that comes down from up there to down here. So I need to dig out some of this crap and stumps, clear all the rotting logs and smooth it out mostly. So you guys can see what I had here last year. And now we have this thing here. I think it's mildly better. I would say about maybe 5.5% better. From down here, the thing looks what it looks. Personally, I think it's awesome. I really like how the railings came out in this video. The staircase was a complete nightmare, as is everything with what I do. I think the thing took me like 2.5 days to build. I have no idea why it took me that long. I was pretty fed up with this build, but overall I think it came out great. And the railings, pretty straightforward and simple. I think putting timber in timber is really something. So yeah, I think this episode came out pretty good. And overall I'm really happy how this entire porch area looks. By the way, the only reason I added this extra roof on here was to fix that overlap issue. At the time I thought that's gonna be a quick and easy fix. Well, it wasn't that quick and that easy. But I think it overall improves the situation on this building. I'm hoping this building will be here at least another 100 years. With that being said, I think I got everything sorted out that I wanted to sort out in this video. And wait a minute. I also promised to add something here. How did I forget about this? What the hell? crazy how these two bigger rocks fitted together so nicely.
They were like meant for this purpose.
Because now everything is finished. Probably should add some kind of a door here. Or a fence thing. Just so geese would not just run into the abyss down there. This video will never end. So I found this old, what do you call this thing? Children's or toddler's bed frame thing. Basically I was like, maybe I can use it here. Couple of hinges and couple of magnets and we're good to go.
Kinda crazy how this thing just fits here so nicely. Its height is like it was designed for this spot. Perfectly flush from the top. And almost flush from the bottom.
That guide rail should do something useful. Anyway, I think that's about it. Should probably wrap this video up now, because this is getting kinda ridiculous at this point. So anyway, in the next video, I will be focusing on installing the windows and doors. But until then, I'm signing off. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!